since he's been here, he's watched 3 games in the Ghana Premier League. He arrived the very day the competition started. So on the 29th, when we played our first Premier League game, it was Accra Lions versus Elmina Sharks at the Accra Sports Stadium. He was in attendance. He watched that game. Then the following day was when Dreams FC hosted Asante Kotoko at the same venue. Coach Milovan Rajevac was there again. Then on the third day, when Hearts of Oak played Lagos Cities, he was still at the Accra Sports Stadium. So since the league started, he's actually watched all 3 games that were played at the Accra Sports Stadium. Now, at this moment, I'll hand over to assistant coach Maxwell Konedu for him to give us the list or the squad list for the 2 matches. Coach.
Thank you very much. You're all welcome, sir. We have a 28-man squad here that coach gave us. The goalkeepers, we have yourself, Olako, Swindon Town, Lawrence Atizigi, St. Gallen, and I have no regain, open Richard Atta, as of all. The defenders are and the Yadam, Redden FC, Philemon Balfour, Dreams FC, Baba Rahman, Redden, Gideon Mensah, Bodo, Daniel Amate, Leicester City, Alexander Yiku, Strasbourg, Joseph Edu, South Africa, Jonathan Mensah, Columbus Crew, Ishmael Ganim, Asante Kotoko. The midfielders are Baba Ibisu, Ray Mayoka, Thomas Partey, Arsenal, Mubarak, Wakasu, Shenzhen FC of China, Edmund Addo, Sheriff Tiraspol, Mohamed Kudus, Ajax Amsterdam, and Daniel Kofi Chre, FC Saint Paul. Wingers are Andrea Yu Asa, Jordan Ayu, Crystal Palace, Abdul Fatah Shaku, Dreams FC, Kamaldin Suleiman, Saad Rene, Samuel Ousu, Al Fire. Strikers are Richmond Kwachigano, Beta Jerusalem, Benjamin Tete, Yeni Malat Yaspor, Felix Afena Gyan, AS Roma, and Khaled Ekuba of Genoa. Thank you very much.
Okay, so those are the players for the 2 matches. 28 players called up by the head coach. If there is a microphone amongst you, I would like to now invite your questions. You raise your hand, you mention your name and your media house, and then you ask your question. Let me remind those of us who are watching us on Facebook that we are live across our platforms on Facebook, and then also all our social media handles at Ghana Football Association. So the coach is ready for your questions. Just raise your hand, they will bring the microphone to you, and then you ask a question.
Nisha, use this mic. I think it's put it on.
Okay, the gentleman in black. So that is my question.
Yes.
Okay, keep it there. So initially we were told that the national stadium in Ethiopia has been closed down by CAF and FIFA based on reports following their games against Zimbabwe and South Africa. So they were looking for a place to host a game against Ghana. They wrote to Kenya. And then we were notified, and later they wrote to South Africa, and we were again notified. But as soon as the issue of South Africa came up, we sent a petition to FIFA. We wanted FIFA to respect its own fair play rule. We expected FIFA to do something about it. But the truth is that venues for games are not in every football law. It is not in any football regulation. It is the prerogative of the home team to decide where they want to play their match. And you that are waiting, you are only notified in writing by the organizer of the competition. So there was not much we could do, even though we sent an official petition to FIFA. As things stand, FIFA has written to us that they will respect the fair play. They will make sure the right things are done. They have also appointed a security officer in charge of the game, which we have been notified to that effect. So as a nation, we did what we could to probably, convince FIFA that they should change the venue, but they came back to us, giving us assurances that all is well, playing the game in Johannesburg. So the game is going on according to schedule at the Orlando Stadium in Johannesburg, South Africa. Thank you. Okay, the gentleman at the back. You, yes. Is a woman?
Yes.
Really? Okay. Deceived by a nose mask.
Okay, good afternoon.
Afternoon.
Please, my name is Sierra Lilian from Human and Democracy. When I call up with Edmund Addo, please, you know, give respect. I want to know, is it because he played with Real Madrid and he played war? That is why we called him for the monitoring since from day one. Thank you.
As Edmund Addo,
dobro, on se nametno sa igrama njegovog tima. Napravili su stvarno fenomenalne rezultate I jednostavno punije energije, punije naboja. Pre toga su eliminisali Crvenu zvezdu iz Beograda, Dinamo iz Zagreba, Real iz Madrida I jednostavno išao sam, gledao sam utakmicu koju su igrali protiv Intera u Milanu. Video sam, ta pozicija nam treba I to dali smo mu šansu da zaigra za reprezentaciju.
I was monitoring the form of this player since he and his team were playing very well in the past period. They eliminated two strong teams, Red Star Belgrade and Dinamo Zagreb, so they qualified for the Champions League, which was great achievement. Their performances in the Champions League were excellent, and this is why he was noticed. And I went to see the match against Inter Milan 2 weeks ago, so he deserved his call up. And it's important, this position is important for us in the team, so we want to have all available players and the players who can respond to my requirements. So this is why he received his call up, and we are lucky to have him here.
Okay, Akusia. Aisha. Okay.
Dobro, mlada reprezentacija, uvek te mlade igrače pozivamo, dajemo im šansu, oni su bili prvaci Afrike, tako da I gledali smo ga neke utakmice, tako da zadovoljava, znači na širem spisku I na njemu je da u budućnosti uzme šansu I da uđe prvi tim.
As you know, this position of the right fullback was a little bit deficit for us, and this young player played for under 20 Ghana. They won the African Cup for under 20, so he definitely deserved his call up. I like to rely on young players, and I like to give chance to young players. And at this moment, he really delivers good performances, and even he started playing with his team in the local league. So this is the best option for now. Of course, in the future, we will always look for the best possible options for every position in the team.
Okay, George.
Hello, coach. How are you? Nice.
Nice. Thank you.
I would just do a quick follow-up on the question, and then I'll ask my question, just a quick one. Because in the first, or the qualifiers, the one that you handled, the games involving Zimbabwe, you know, back in the to and fro, you didn't feel that Philemon Mafo was good enough to be at the right back. You can tell me if I'm wrong.
Da možeš u ovom desnom beku, u ove prve dve
utakmice. From what I was watching it, I thought you felt that Filimon was not good enough. And so you started Alante, you know, in an improvised position. So I want you to tell me what you think will change, or what you're hoping changes about Filimon Bafo to give him a chance in the team. That is my first question. My second question is, I saw you take a picture with Edmund Addo. I see he's in there. Feels to me that you were on a journey to try and convince other players. How many of such players did you speak to? Because we know there's some really young players, young boys, who don't exactly feel like playing for us. Which other players did you meet and how did all of them
meet?
Prvo odgovori za Voga, kaži da... Ko je bilo? Da, to meni question sam.
Prvo odgovori za Voga, kaži da nisi...
So just two. Let's start with the first one. What do you think we improve about Filimon Bafo? What are you hoping to improve about?
Što ga ne znaš još dovoljno, ovo me više veruješ zato što je...
Dobro, vidjeli ste kako je postavljena utakmica. Tu sam išao na iskusnije igrače, na zadnju liniju vidjeli ste da našto u prvoj utakmici smo dosta bili ofanzivni i taj zadnji blok je bio iskusan i napravio jedan beden ispred našeg tima što se nismo smeli, kažem, malo je vremena da upoznam sve igrače, da ali naročito tu zadnju liniju smo napravili da ne primamo golove i mislim da smo tu dosta uspjeli. Sigurno da ću ja upoznati bolje igrače i svakoga pojedinačno i vidjeti ko mi treba u igri da namislim tako šta mi više odgovara. Tako kažem, uvijek će neko izaći od tih mlađih igrača koji će sigurno dobiti šansu, na njima je da iskoriste šansu kad je dobio da iskoriste. To je to.
I think I explained this already because you know that I came recently and before these two matches there was no space to make a mistake and I had to make sure that I rely on the players I know better. So that's why I used Daniel Amarte because we couldn't make a mistake. We had to want to win these matches, so I choose the option I know better. This player, Filimon, is still young, and of course, for young players, it's important when they get their chance, they have to use it. So I choose what is the most secure option for me at that moment, and it proved right for me. So this was the only reason I wanted to have strong and tall defense, so I make sure that we don't concede unnecessary goals and we can win these two matches. Apart from that, for second question,
bio sam, gledao sam igrače, neke igrače, baš me interesovalo jer malo je vremena i htio sam bolje da ju poznam, tako sam išao da gledam Kjerea, išao sam da gledam Kjerea u Njemačkoj, igrali su utakmicu i baš me ovako impresionirao na toj utakmici što ono nisam mogao da vidim na treningu. Druga stvar, bio sam u Milanu, gledao sam Inter i Šerif, tako da imam bolju sliku, znači i to će mi biti naredni posao da sve igrače, sve potencijalne reprezentativce gledam, da se uverim kako igraju za svoje timove i jednostavno da probam da ih uklopim u našu igru.
Yes, you're right. I was there to watch Inter Milan against Sheriff match. This is part of my work. After this match, I went to see Daniel Coficiere in St. Paul because I'm getting to know these players and I want to see them in action, how they performed in their clubs. This is the best way you can get to know them better and to see their abilities and skills and how much they can contribute to the national team. Of course, my plan is to see many players in the future. I
don't want to,
of course, as I said, I'm watching the local league. This is also a very important part of my work, and as well to monitor the players who are playing abroad in respectable leagues. My plan is to see many of the players in the future, of course. First of all, I have to get in touch with those players to check their availability, if they're ready to play for the Black Stars, before I go to see them in action. So this is part of my work, and you know, there is a lot of work ahead of me. So my associates also, Max and Otto, they are also doing immense work in this area. So this is part of our job, and we have to make sure that we have the best players available for the Black Stars in the future.
Goalkeeper coach.
And also Lele as well is monitoring goalkeepers. You saw the previous time he suggested Joseph Olakot, and there are also other goalkeepers on our radar. So what we want is the best for the team, the best for the Black Stars and for this country. So we are going to try to have the best players at our disposal.
Okay, you. Butela, the musician.
I want to ask our right back position. We have a man Zinana who plays for SK Zelina. And he's playing very well. And he always plays the game in time. So why is he not included? We are going to South Africa. We know that they are part of the real estate countries. As we are going there, would the UK-based players
da li će ovim imati problema igrači iz Velike Britanije, ma ne. Kažem, pratimo tog igrača, znamo.
Da, pratimo tog igrača, znamo i želimo da pratimo ga, kao i sve igrače. I jednostavno kažem, pratit ćemo i dalje i vidjet ćemo da li, da li zasluže. Tako da, kažem, pratit ćemo.
A igrači će moći.
Igrači će, savjet se sve uradio da mogu da naprave papire i da idemo u Južnu Afriku.
Of course, we are aware of Enzanana playing for Žilina, and we are monitoring him alongside with many other players. So it's a process, and you know, definitely for every player it's important to keep their performances and to do their best so they can deserve the call from the national team. Apart from that, for South Africa, everything should be okay. GFA did everything to make sure that we follow all the protocols and that players are available for this match and for visas and everything, so everything should be okay.
Nikui. Pratimo njegovu formu, bori se za svoje mjesto u timu, prvo da se ustali u timu. Gledali smo juče, tako da imat ćemo razgovor posle ovog sastanka sa njim.
Of course, we are monitoring his situation. In the past, we know that he felt it was not the right time for him. He was trying to establish himself in the past for Leicester City, and now in Club Brugge. Yesterday he entered the match against City as a substitute, so we are in touch, and after these matches, coach's plan is to go and visit him, talk to him, and check his availability for the next match, because he's a wonderful prospect and definitely the player that coach is thinking about him seriously for the future.
Okay.
My name is Douglas, I'm basically a
igrača prema što je pozovete.
Pa normalno, gledamo poziciju u timu koje su nam, koje nam trebaju. I normalno, ja imam svoje zahteve kako na svakoj poziciji treba odigrati. Jednostavno, to je to što, što i svaki dobar igrač, pazite, forma znači kod svakog igrača je nešto individualno i svako kad dođe u dobru formu treba što duže da je održi i da jedno se, tako se nametne ovaj, da bi ga pozvao za ekipu i da bi igrao u ekipi.
Every position in the team has some requirements and what is important for me from the player to meet my requirements according to the position in
the team.
Of course, I want to have a competition in my team, to have at least two players to fight for each position in the team. Form is important. So when player is in a good form, this is something that usually recommends him to receive the call up. So there are many, many important things. And but as I said, for every position, there are some requirements, and that something that I expect if I notice that the player can deliver and the player can contribute to the team and play according to my expectation, this is a good recommendation for the player, and this player will be invited.
Okay.
Da, pošto se ono je euforik povredio, pa nije... Pojavljuju se u timu, ali ne igra. Ona je u švajcarski gol.
Ču li ja?
Da, da.
Da kažem... I
pa jednostavno imamo uvek, procenimo situaciju. On je dobro,
dobro, dobro. Nekako najmanje, najmanje što...
Dobro, novo koji se nametilo.
Da. Mislim da, da, da je Jojo odradio dobro posao i da, da smo dobro procenili. Kad su u pitanju golmani, kad su u pitanju golmani, tu smo mi sve i kad su u pitanju igrači, znači ja, da kažem, ne odlučujem sam sa mojim saradnicima, podelimo mišljenja i jednostavno pred ove dve utakmice svi smo iskazali sa treninga da, da dobro radi, da mislimo da može i on je to opravdao.
As you all know, you have to, you need to have more than one goalkeeper, you know, in the team. And I always talk to my associates. And
please, Joyce, please give me that mic.
Okay. As you well know, we need to rely on few goalkeepers. It's important, especially in this time. Lorenz Atizigi is doing a great job, but in the last camp, Jojo Wolakot came and he assured all of us that he deserved a chance. But of course, we count on all of these guys. You know, it's important to have them around. So there are many circumstances that can happen. So I trust all of them, and I always speak to my assistants, and we share our thoughts, share our opinions, and we always try to choose what is the best for the team at the particular moment.
No, keep it.
Next to this game, my second question is, are you
invitation was sent to Magina Shimeru overnight. Why is it that this name didn't appear in the squad?
Nije pozvano ovaj Magina Shimeru iz Anderlecht.
You know that he had an invitation. Really?
No, he said
an invitation was sent, so it cannot be a question. It's a statement of fact. Unfortunately, the coach cannot answer that. He has chosen 28 players who must be in camp, must prepare for the game. We cannot speak about players who are outside the squad. Sorry. Now, the first issue about Andy Addo. Andy came into contact with somebody with COVID last week. Because of that, he needed to go, out of the team. He was isolated from the Reading squad. Now, once he was isolated, he needed to go through COVID test. Now, when the COVID test was conducted, the result delayed until the day of the match, and he couldn't prove whether he was positive or negative. That's why he couldn't play that game on Tuesday. As we speak, we've spoken to him. The test results are out, and he's negative. So he will surely be with the team. Thank you. Next question, please. Uthman, come forward. Betiosi. Uthman, come forward.
Well, coach, you have called your best 28 players, and I mean, we've seen you won your game back to back. Now, going into the game against Ethiopia and South Africa, Ghanaians want to be assured if you are qualifying to the World Cup. So, this is to you. Is Ghana qualifying to the World Cup?
Pa svi se nadamo da ćemo se kvalifikovati. Konkretno pitanje, da?
Nadamo se da hoćemo.
Nadamo se da hoćemo i vjerujemo da hoćemo, da se kvalifikujemo. Treba svi, prvo kad sam došao drugi put ovdje, rekao sam da svi treba da budemo na tom putu da se kvalifikujemo. Sad koliko ćemo uspjeti, ja mislim da ćemo uspjeti da se Ghana kvalifikuje za svjetsko prvenstvo. A ako se Ghana kvalifikuje za svjetsko prvenstvo, sigurno da ću ja biti najsrećniji čovjek na svijetu.
We really hope for that, you know, we are all working, this is our agenda, you know, and every person here, every member of the federation, every member of the technical team, every player, we all want the same thing. And if we qualify for the World Cup, I will be the happiest man on the world. So definitely, we will all give our best to make that happen. Of course, we cannot predict future, you know. It's impossible, but we are doing everything in our power to win next matches. You know, this is our goal, and we will do our best to make it happen.
Okay, the gentleman at the back.
Okay, coach, my name is Sarioja Fukosefe. Please. Recently, we had problems with regards to goal scoring, that is the center forward. There was a time that we needed to deploy Andrea Yu as the main center forward, even though he's not.
Nekad smo stavljali ideja da budem napad,
da
smo imali problema.
Per the list, you hear the name of Richmond Boateng.
You know Richmond
Boateng. He was part of the team some times back. What do you make of him? Do you think he has what it takes to solve our goal scoring problems? And then, just a favor before the press conference will end, we want you to run over the list again. Yeah, little thing. Thank you.
Znam ga dobro iz Crvene zvezde, dok igra u Crvenoj zvezdi i vidi se tamo njegovi rekordi. Mislim da je, pozvali smo ga sada, mislim da je italijanska škola, da dosta zna da se otvara, da će mnogo pomoći timu. Jednostavno, tražimo, tragamo za igračem koji će biti najistureniji. Normalno, svi mogu da daju golove, evo, Tomas je dao dva gola, on je sad trenutno ove dve utakmice najbolji strelac, znači svi mogu da daju golove, ali normalno moramo imati tog, da kažem, glavnog čoveka koji će ili davati golove ili namještati drugima, ili ali mislim da on ima, da je to pokazao ranije, vidjet ćemo sad u kakvoj je formi i dali smo mu šansu da dođe, jednostavno na njemu je da proba danas, da iskoristi šansu i da pomogne Gani.
If you look at his previous records, playing for the Red Star, playing the Champions League, Europa League, look at the statistics, we know this player very, very well. This player is Italian school, he has excellent movements, he's tactically very, very quality player. He's coming back after some difficult period, and he started playing for the new team recently. He started scoring some goals. He has experience, he has skills, and he deserves a chance. So it's upon him to prove himself, because in football you always have to prove yourself when you play. Strikers are not the only players who are scoring goals. If you look at the previous two matches, Thomas Partey scored two goals. So any player can score a goal. But it's always good to have the player in the attack who can score goal easily or assist. So definitely, as I said, he deserves his chance, and I believe in his qualities, and it's up to him to prove himself when he arrives.
Okay, we've got just about 10 minutes to wrap up. Three questions and we are done. Uthman.
Yeah, Coach. My question is to do with the inclusion of Felix Afena Gyan. Do you seriously think he has done enough to
Pa dobro, čim je stekao povjerenje jednog takvog trenera, jednog takvog tima, da ima toliko godina, i mislim da je to budućnost sigurno fudbala u Gani, naročito ta pozicija, kad oni vide da mu daju šansu, zašto i mi ne bi dali šansu.
I believe that people from FC Roma and Mourinho is a famous coach, he's well known for his accomplishments in his career, if they are assured to give him chance, for example, last match he played against AC Milan for second half, and if they think that he's a very young player and he has prospect, definitely we can see according to his performance that he's definitely promising talent, so why shouldn't we be assured that he deserves a chance? I think he's definitely promising talent, and he should be around here, and he should be the part of this squad, because we always have to look for the future and we have to establish quality players for our upcoming challenges.
Okay, Obiwa.
Hello, Coach. What's the situation with Afrikanka? The last time he was part of the squad, he was asked to be excused at this time around. He's not part of the team. What is the situation with Afrikanka? Have you spoken with him? What is the situation with him?
Da li da prebaci na Maks?
Pa ne moraš, kaži samo da ga pratimo i da smo pričali sa
njim. Da, pratimo ga i bili smo u razgovoru sa njim. Imaju neku povredu, vukao je tu povredu, pričali smo sa njim. Sad, zadnje vreme, isto ima povredu, nije igrao zadnju takticu.
We talked to him recently before the previous camp. He had some light injury. He was in and out of the first 11, last match he was on the bench, so at this moment this is my decision not to include him, but as I said, I'm monitoring every player, and each player has to impress me, so he gets invited to the national team, so it's not a difference for him or anybody else, so they all should keep playing well, and when they get the chance they have to use it.
Yes.
My name is Ishmael from Hampton FM. I want to ask the coach, our local strikers, are they not good enough to end the collab? Or they didn't have enough time?
Dobri da,
ali nije bilo dovoljno. To će da prebacimo.
Max.
Ok. Ako mogu, ako mogu ovo pitanje da prebacim na Max. On
okay,
je zadužen za to.
Max. Max is in charge.
Yeah, thank you very much, coach.
The league just started.
We just started our league. And coach is here watching every game, every week.
Last one.
So let's be patient with coach. At the right time, you see them coming up. Thank you.
My name is Dokumenti. I want to ask the coach, anytime there is a backstab come up, a lot of Ghanaians are calling for Ibrahim Salifu, who's supposed to be the best player for the Ghana Premier League. And the call up is in now. He's still not in the call up. Is it because he's not mature to play the backstab, or what happens?
Yeah.
Ok,
pazite, da, ovaj, liga je sad počela i uobičajeno da ne govorimo o pojedincima, ali ovdje, ajde, sad smo počeli da pričamo o pojedincima, koga, ko je pozvan, ko nije i tako dalje i tako dalje. Mislim da nije glavna tema to, objašnjavati ko je sad najbolji, ko je pitanje, ovaj, tako da, kažem, mi pratimo, skoro smo ovdje. Prvi kamp nam je bio fenomenalan, dobro je uspio, nadamo se i drugi kamp, tako da ovaj, svi ti igrači koji su pozvani na širi spisak, dali smo im šansu. Sad ko će od njih da uhvati šansu, vidjet ćemo, ko ne, znači imat ćemo dalje. Da.
Of course we are aware of all the players here, especially about him, so as I said before, the league has just started, you know, and usually players need some time to get into right shape and proper fitness. So as I said before, I will monitor the league and my assistants will also do the same thing. So you shouldn't be surprised if you see him or some other names in the national teams in the future. So I usually don't like to discuss about individuals in this way. You know, this is maybe not the best way how we can talk about when it comes to the national team. But as I said, I will do my best together with my associates to monitor every player who is eligible to play for Ghana and try to, because I don't have any favorites, you know, I just want to when I'm assured, I want to pick the player who can contribute the team so team can perform better and team can progress to the next stage. So as I said, we will all do our best to monitor all of them and to invite the best of them for the team.
Okay, last one, Joyce.
Coach, my name is Joyce. Yeah. And I'm coming from Top FM. I want to ask
you
if you are building a team for Nations Cup, because the Nations Cup is only 2 months, but every day you call a new player. What is your vision for them?
Koja je vizija za Afrički kup i to?
Svaka prva utakmica je najvažnija. Afrički kup će doći posle ove dve utakmice, tako da trenutno razmišljamo o prvoj utakmici i to nam je najvažnija utakmica. Tako u Afričkom kupu ćemo razmišljati, imat ćemo dovoljno vremena da odradimo treninge i da napravimo onakvu igru kako hoćemo, a hoćemo da napravimo da bude najlepša, najbolja i najuspješnija.
As I said before, for me the next match is the most important match and at this moment I'm not thinking about AFCON, I'm thinking about the next match. And this is something that is the most important for me. We are in process of making the team, and when we will have time for AFCON, especially I'm very happy because I will have time to work with the team. I will have many training sessions, so I can do exactly the things I want, and players can meet my requirements. This will be the first time that you have more time, many training sessions, so you can establish something that you want. As I said, we are not focusing on AFCON at this moment. these next matches are the most important for us, so we just focus to win these next two matches so we can finish this part of the campaign as first on the table and achieve our goal.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I think that will be it. I would like to thank you for your company on behalf of the head coach of the team, Milovan Rajevac, and assistant coach Maxwell Konedu. We also have with us the team manager of the Black Stars, Henry Mate, joining us. Henry, shall we please acknowledge him? So the information is that we are looking ahead to the players arriving on Monday, that is hopefully next week Monday, and we are likely to depart Accra on Tuesday afternoon to South Africa. The game is on Thursday, so at least we'll have one full day to train and to recover and play the game on Thursday. And the second game against South Africa will be played on Sunday, 14th November. So that is the program for now. As and when different information or news trickle in, we'll update you on our social media handles as well as the Ghana Football Association website. Once again, thanks for your company and good afternoon. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, really?
Am I ready?